Hey folks, here we are back at the National Atomic Testing Museum for the third and final part of the Nuclear Test Site series, and boy do we have a treat in store for you today. In the previous episodes, we learned about why Nevada was chosen as the test site location and what kind of testing and development was done there during and after the Cold War. Today, we're going to get a look at the quirky, bizarre, and utterly awesome impact atomic testing had on our American culture, with Las Vegas being ground zero for a marketing explosion that only us wacky Americans could do. So let's go inside and check out this fantastic tribute to American pop culture, nuclear era style.
Got a doll, baby, I love her so. Nothing else like her anywhere you go. A man, she's anything but calm. Regular pint-size atom bomb.
Atom bomb, baby, little atom bomb. I want her in my wigwam. She's just the way I want her to be. A million times hotter than TNT.
Now, as we learned, the Nevada National Security Site is only about 65 miles north of Las Vegas, so atomic blasts lighting up the horizon became a familiar sight in the early 50s. But leave it to Vegas to capitalize on such a thing and turn it into a cultural phenomenon. In the span of just a few years, the population of Las Vegas grew from about 25,000 to nearly 60,000, primarily due to the fact that the establishment of the test site and the subsequent testing led to the creation of thousands of jobs and brought in millions of dollars of federal funding into the region, which significantly boosted the economy. On April 22, 1952, KTLA of Los Angeles broadcast the first atomic test, and atomic fever instantaneously swept over the country. The nuclear era had arrived, and industry was quick to capitalize on it. In no time at all, Las Vegas clubs were hosting viewing parties and serving atomic-themed cocktails, while showgirls sported atomic-themed outfits. Across the country, kids were playing with atomic-themed toys and becoming junior atomic scientists with home atomic lab testing kits and prospecting for radioactive ores with home-use Geiger counters. Fallout shelters became a hot commodity for the real estate market, and science fiction books, comics, and films had a heyday as people flocked to theaters for a glimpse into an atomic future. It was a bizarre moment in American history like no other, where the Mad Men marketing agencies transformed the most destructive weapon ever created into a pop culture sensation and laid the groundwork for what would eventually become the true soul of our Fallout universe and the heart of the wasteland as we know it from the game. So Joe, what do we have here?
So this is our pop culture exhibit, Chip. This is where we talk about all the great pop culture pieces that came out during the early popularity of the atomic bomb. Now, with the first televised nuclear test in 1952, an atomic craze swept the United States. So you had a lot of companies capitalizing on that popularity of the atomic bomb by creating everything from atomic toy guns.
Oh, cool.
To comic books, atomic fireball candies, and even an atomic energy lab.
Boy, oh boy, just looking in this case takes me right home. I mean, gosh, from the comic books to the cereal boxes to the toys, you think you're in my bedroom.
You got to accentuate the positive, even mind it the negative.
And one thing I always like to point out to our visitors is this right here. This is a Wildcat Echo. It is the Las Vegas High School yearbook from 1953. And we love to point that out because it shows just how much the atomic bomb and the Nevada test site really impacted Las Vegas. In 1950, there was only about less than 25,000 people living in Las Vegas. And by 1960, that exploded to 65,000 people. So these students would all know at least one person who worked at the site, while money and jobs came to the city of Las Vegas.
Wow, I had no idea that many people worked there. Oh, and folks, just looking at this case really makes you appreciate the attention to real-world detail the wonderful game designers and artists have an eye for. These fantastic items are unmistakably the inspiration for so many of the props in the game that scream of the zaniness of the duck and cover era of the 1950s, and what gives Fallout a soul and style so at home in our history and in the real world.
While I start reviewing the attitude of doing right.
You gotta accentuate the positive feeling. Mine ain't the negative, latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between.
You got to spread joy
up to the maximum.
Bring gloom
down
to the minimum.
Then
Otherwise, I'm liable to walk upon the scene.
To illustrate.
Gosh, that's an awesome display, Joe. And I encourage all the Fallout fans to spend some time and enjoy this exhibit. So what's this?
This is one of our hands-on activities here at the National Atomic Test Museum. This is a Geiger counter. This is how folks dealing with anything radioactive are able to detect levels of radiation. And I'll show you how it works.
Oh, cool.
So we have some sources here at the museum, such as a radium clock. We have some Fiestaware pieces and even some shillings we can experiment. You want to try it out?
Oh, sure. Thank you.
Cool.
This is so cool. That is a...
Let me see that.
Well, you know, maybe...
Chip, I don't know what you've been up to, but we gotta get you out of here. Let's go.
Hey, what about the gift shop?
Gotta get you out of here, Chip.
I mean, it was just a little radiation.
More than a little.
Is there a Starbucks?
Bye, see ya.
Oh, okay. Bye, Joe.
So here at the museum, we have our magnificent gift shop with our amazing staff. And in our gift shop, you can find everything from kooky-named sodas, t-shirts, science kits, books, and also in the back we have hand-painted rock slabs and glasses made by Betty, hand-painted by Betty, who used to work out at the Nevada Test Site. The next time you find yourself in Las Vegas, Nevada, be sure to stop by the National Atomic Test Museum. You'll have a blast.
Aw, double dog, darn it. Stupid radiation. Well, folks, there you have it. This was one fantastic museum and a must-place visit for any Fallout fan and certainly anyone wanting to learn more about the U.S. nuclear weapons program and the Nevada National Security Site. The exhibits are fascinating and educational. The staff are amazing and enthusiastic people, highly knowledgeable in the history and culture of one of the strangest times in American history, the nuclear era. I can't recommend this museum enough. Everybody traveling to Vegas needs to stop and visit this fantastic museum. And Joe, I am so glad and so grateful for the opportunity to come and visit this eye-opening museum. The impact it's had on me has been tremendous. To see firsthand and get an objective glimpse of the work done at the test site and reflect on our responsibilities as a nation, it's an incredible experience and just so inspiring. Thank you so much for sharing this with us and with the world.
My pleasure, Chip, and I hope you and the rest of your followers come and visit us again soon.
Oh, I guarantee it. I'll spread the word, and I hope that every Fallout fan can come here and have a chance to experience this fantastic museum. Joe, thank you so much for having us.
Thank you, Chip. Thank you. Bye, everyone.
So before we say goodbye to the test site, let's visit one more exciting spot, Area 51. Well, okay, not the real Area 51. I mean, that doesn't really exist, does it? Well, if it does, you're absolutely not going to be visiting. But what you can visit is a place arguably as amazing, and it won't land you in prison. About 90 miles north of Las Vegas, at the intersection of State Routes 95 and 373 in the Armagosa Valley, you'll discover the Area 51 Alien Center, a must and legal stop for all you alien enthusiasts and UFOologists. It's a fun-filled place open year-round from 7 a.m. to 11 p.m., as it's also a gas station and travel center. You can't miss it from the outside, not with that colorful alien-themed paint job. So walk around and explore and snap a few fun-filled pictures before heading inside. Once inside, you'll discover an awesome store filled with more alien merch than you'll find anywhere else on Earth. There's lots of mugs, shot glasses, and all manner of unique alien gifts. There's tons of apparel, including all sorts of hats, and a huge selection of tees with dozens of alien and UFO themed designs. And don't forget to stop at the Alien Cafe Diner in the back for some great eats and a one-of-a-kind dining experience.
And the oldest alien fortune teller in the universe.
And before you leave, be sure to get your fortune from an alien Zoltar. Oh, jeepers, he's gone intergalactic.
I've got some words of wisdom for you. Just come closer.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, the last time I got close to one of you Zetons, it didn't go well. So I'd want to probe. I mean, and I hope you don't. But I'm just curious, is there really an Area 51? Sorry, didn't get that. So if you want to see the pop culture surrounding the Nevada National Security Site, literally, this place is ground zero. Sorry, Coyote. I had to. And that does it for the test site. If you can't visit the real one, definitely visit the museum.